Hello to everyone, I'm Marco Raffaele, postdoc at the International Clinic Research Center of Brno, and today I'm sharing with you my data on the effect of senolytic cocktail dasatinib plus quercetin on a mice model of NAFLD, the most common obesity and age-dependent liver disease. NAFLD, or non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, is a pathology that presents in an asymptomatic accumulation of fat in the liver that exceed the 5% of the volume of the entire organ. This metabolic disorder can progress to non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, characterized by fibrosis and inflammation, and can lead to develop cirrhosis and hepatocellular carcinoma. Today, NAFLD represents the most common liver disease worldwide, with an incidence in the general population greater than 25%. Which increased dramatically up to 40% when individuals over 60 years old are considered. Moreover, NAFLD is strictly related with obesity and insulin resistance, by which co-presence accelerates the disease progression. High fat diet, sedentary lifestyle, and aging are among the major risk factors to develop NAFLD. The metabolic imbalance induced by this element leads to an increased lipid accumulation and reactive oxygen species production into the hepatocyte, resulting in mitochondrial dysfunction, DNA damage, and telomere shortening. Recently, it has been shown that patients with NAFLD present elevated expression of senescence marker and increased production of the senescent-associated secretory phenotype in the hepatocyte. For cell senescence, it's a cellular response to different stress factors characterized by a stable growth arrest and other phenotypic alterations that include, among others, the upregulation of tumor suppressor P16, an increased level of lysosomal beta-galactosidase, and a pathway of pro-inflammatory molecules. Physiologically, senescence plays roles in normal development, maintains tissue homeostasis, and limits tumor progression. But when the senescent cell burden raises due to the stressor agent, such as irradiation, chemotherapy drugs, or ROS, it can aggravate the condition of many pathology, including cancer and age-related disease. For this reason, cellular senescence has rapid gaining interest as potential therapeutic target. The agents used to selectively induce the apoptosis of senescent cell are called senolytics. In the past decade, different senolytic families were discovered, and currently most of the senolytic can be classified as BCL family inhibitor, PI3K AKT inhibitor, and FOXO regulators. The way to act of these senolytics is usually targeting one of more or more pro-survival and anti-apoptotic pathway, which guarantee the holding of cell senescent status. Among them, have been used in combination. Two of them have been used in combination, showing a synergic activity, a good efficacy in many in vitro and in vivo models. And these two are dasatinib, that is a tyrosine kinase inhibitor with a chemotherapeutic use, and quercetin, a plant flavonoid with PI3K AKT inhibitor activity. This senolytic cocktail showed in a recent study published on aging that NAFLD pathology is driven by cellular senescence. However, this previous report did not analyze the effectiveness of the senolytics in hampering the progression of NAFLD into inflammatory state and finally into hepatocellular carcinoma. To test this hypothesis, we adopt a well-established mouse model of NAFLD-induced hepatocellular carcinoma, where young mice, 7 weeks old, are administrated with low dose of a carcinogen compound called dienotrosamine, followed by feeding a high-fat diet containing the 60% of energy from lard. The mice, the animal, were fed with a fat diet from the seventh week to the 43rd weeks, when the animals were sacrificed for the analysis. Four groups of 20 mice each were created: the group one, that included control and treated mice; the group two, that were mice treated with the D+Q; and the third group, that included the just mentioned DANAF diet protocol. Finally, the group four was the DANAF diet mice treated with senolytics D+Q. At the end of the experiment, the DANAF diet groups exhibited a 50% increase in body weight with a no tangible effect of D+Q treatment. We then investigate the ability of the four groups of mice to respond to a glucose challenge as a readout of metabolic health. In glucose tolerance tests, glucose levels were significantly higher in DANAF diet mice at 90 and 120 minutes time point compared to control. But D+Q administration, as we can see in the group 2 and the group 4, did not have any significant effect on GTT curves. The blood analysis showed no differences in the number of white blood cells and red blood cells count, as well in hemoglobin levels among the four groups. Upon alpha diet feeding, biochemical plasma analysis in table 2 detected a significant increase in the level of low-density lipoprotein, high-density lipoprotein, total cholesterol, and ALT/AST transaminase, while we observe a paradoxical decrease in triglyceride, that most likely due to a reduced dietary carbohydrate incoming compared to the control diet. None of these changes were affected by D+Q treatment. We then conducted a histopathological assessment of D+Q effect on liver parenchymal architecture, and this figure shows representative image of hematoxylin and eosin staining of liver section of mice fed with control diet or alpha diet and treated with D+Q. Steatosis reached the maximum score of 3 in the alpha diet, as we can see in the graph, and only a value of 1 was assigned to the control diet group, identifying a mild steatosis probably caused by aging. Several hepatocyte ballooning was also noticed in the liver of alpha diet mice, while only a small number was detected in the liver control diet mice. In both diet groups, D+Q did not show to improve liver health, obtaining similar steatosis and ballooning score compared to their respective control. The increased fat storage in the liver of mice fed with a fat diet was corroborated by the increased expression of level of key lipogenic genes, such as PPAR-gamma, NCBA, the lipid droplet growth-related genes PLIN2, SADC, and the main membrane fatty acid transporter CD36. While PGC1 alpha, a master regulator of the mitochondrial function, was downregulated in the group upon alpha diet feeding compared to control. In accordance with the fibrotic process that characterized the progression of NAFLD, the level of fibrosis marker as collagenase 1A1 and TIMP1 were strongly upregulated in alpha diet groups compared to control. None of these changes were affected by D+Q treatment. Dysplastic nodules were observed in the panel B. You can see that these dysplastic nodules were observed and classified on their sides in small nodule, if smaller than 3 millimeters, and large nodule if bigger than 3 millimeters. About 35% of the alpha diet mice liver pretreated with a DAN, and surprisingly, 5% of lean mice treated with D plus Q were present in nodules, while none was detected in the lean control. Interestingly, whereas the percentage of tumor-bearing mice in knife-edge control and treated group were similar, a difference in small and large nodule ratio was noted, with an increased presence of large nodule in the alpha diet D plus Q treated group. The senolytic effect of D plus Q treatment was assessed by senescence-associated beta-gal staining and by gene protein expression measurement of the senescence marker P16. As you can see, contrary to previous study, the analysis of beta-gal staining images did not reveal any significant difference in senescent-positive cells number between the treated mice and their control, as shown in the representative image in the panel C. And to support this, in supporting of this beta-gal staining, the evaluation of P16 gene and protein level did not show significant difference among the groups. So, based on this data, we can conclude that NAFLD is strictly correlated with the aging and obesity, and is characterized by an increase in senescent cell burden in the liver. But also that senolytic cocktail was not able to achieve an senescence cell senescence clearance in this model that recapitulates the NAFLD disease progression. And also, D plus Q administration did not affect the glucose and lipid metabolism, while surprisingly, it seems to be have a little pro-tumorogenic effect. From this finding, the clinical use of this compound awaits safety, and more study about timing and dose should be done before the medical translation. I will thank the group leader of my department, Giancarlo Forte, my principal investigator, Mario Vinciguerra, and all my colleagues for their collaboration and their kind support. Thank you for your attention.